yes, he is the son of Hassan Yusuf and they honor Hassan Yusuf, but then he's alone in prison and things can happen. His uncle was there. Actually, his uncle was torturing people that agreed to work for Israel when they arrived to prison, because inside prison, they don't want anybody to spy on them. And he's afraid.
I remember one of the times the Hamas security guys would come and say, everybody evacuate this tent. Now, we leave our stuff, we leave whatever we're doing, they close the tent, nobody can see what's going on, and they turn on all the TVs of the section very loud, and they ask some of the guys to start singing so the soldiers outside don't hear the prisoner screaming. Now, the prisoner was screaming like crazy inside, and we did not know what was happening with him. People that we just get to know, after a couple of days, where are they? Why don't we see them anymore? They're gone. They're just held in that corner, being tortured, their bodies being burned. The Hamas guys put needles under their fingernails, burned plastic on their bodies. There was no limit. Sometimes without evidence, they tortured people to death. We're talking about not one prisoner or two, we're talking about hundreds. I was looking at that picture and I was thinking, this is my father's project. When we sit at home like a family, and my father used to share with us about his goals, he would say, I work for Allah. There is a chance to get killed anytime soon for this project. That's my father telling me that he could get killed for the sake of Hamas, and please to accept. He was saying, please to understand, if anything happens to me, take care of each other, take care of your mom. And I had to hear that again and again and again. I had to witness the Israeli soldiers pulling him from among us and taking him, humiliating him, and putting him in prison for a long time. For what? For the sake of Hamas. Now, here I am in prison and I see Hamas. And that was really shocking.